You just won the first title.
Lowest?
The lowest.
There you go.
The lowest car ever to get a dime.
Right now, we just got the E-gates are working. That is great. Cameron's going over one of my old logs, actually my last fastest pass log.
Three primary. Three secondary.
Yeah, do the primary again.
What is this?
I don't know, but this is the first car that has a backup camera. Look at that. I can see that beautiful black truck inside the car. Look at that. You don't see that every day in a race car. That's crazy. That's crazy. So look at this. This is Michigan registration, 1993 station wagon. Pretty sporty for a station wagon, but man, like your inlet is about two inlets, right? It's about what, four times the stock exhaust on this. It's a sports wagon.
Yeah, it's a sports wagon.
It's more like an ultra sports wagon or something like that. I always remember about the joke. Back in the 90s, they released a saloon on Europe. The Opel Omega, and it was a version that was like spiced up by Lotus, right? So it was the Omega Lotus, right? Or the Carlton, depends on where it was sold. And I think it was Jeremy Clarkson that made that joke, like, that's a family saloon. And like, family saloon for what? The Fittipaldi family or something, you know, because like it doesn't make much sense, right? It's just crazy. Who came up with this idea?
I did.
You did?
Yeah.
So you're having like a good dream about like a wagon, and you tell like, okay, we're gonna make this wagon fast. And then you start like, oh, what can I do with this? I can build like a SMX-41, right? Uh-huh. Water ejected, twin turbo, like, I don't know, it's freaking huge turbos I can see. I don't know the size, but they're huge. I don't want to ask. So, based on the size of the thing, like, it's pretty much like unlimited power, right? It's almost like how much power you want to make. I'm like, okay.
Yeah. It could be.
Like,
it could
be. It's like how much power you have. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
How much power. Boost?
Yes. Yes. How fast it goes? Yes.
Damn. I like all the wood grain stuff. The wood grain intake manifold, the wood grain on the valve covers. That's awesome.
Yeah, there's a bunch of cool details that you guys put on this. Like, obviously, you look at these things like, frick, it's badass wagon. And then you start, you know, looking into the build, like the freaking doors, right? Yeah. Inside the door is just like, that's killer.
Yeah. And the rear, the tub is actually built halfway into the rear door. So the rear door is still open.
Oh, okay.
Can you go in for the door?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, damn it. That'll be fun. The cage. So the cage holding.
Yep.
Man, I have one suggestion. Mm. You need to put two small seats on the back. Like, oh, really tiny seats.
Yeah, the rear rumble seat.
Like, yeah, like really small seats. You know, like maybe put a dog there or something.
Yeah. Kyle used to ride in the back seat when he was just a little kid.
On this one?
Yeah, I've had this car for 20 years.
So this one?
Yeah.
So. Hey buddy, you used to ride on this thing?
Oh yeah.
Do you remember?
In the back seat. I'm
too young to remember that. Did it go 200 back then?
Looking out the back window?
No. I think that thing back in the day would do like 90. 100 downhill or something like lucky. That. You know, if you had balls enough like to go 100 downhill.
Yeah.
And so how fast you been with this thing?
650, 230.
650?
Yeah.
230. On a wagon.
A wagon.
I don't
and
know.
And then drove it 1,000 miles.
I don't know because like there's some people doing like some really cool weird drag racing projects. Like, is this the quickest wagon out there?
As far as I know.
Dang.
A real wagon.
No, a real wagon, yeah, right? Like with four doors steel and stuff like that.
Yeah,
it's all steel.
It's all steel.
So it's all steel, even the hood?
No.
Okay.
The hood's not. The front fenders are.
Okay, that's the rule. Like the rule says that the hood can be composite, yeah. But like the rest of the car is like all steel. Yeah, I can see like the freaking the roof is from 1993.
Had the steel door seal.
Wow. Oh, I bet she's not that loud then, driving.
It's not that bad. It's not as bad as some I've ridden in.
Well, having the exhaust up front though kind of takes a lot of the drone out of the car though, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But then you can hear like 1875.
Oh, yeah, you can. Yeah.
And you get turbo noises.
Oh, I bet you.
Mm-hmm.
Large turbo noises.
Yeah, but like, looking from outside, do you mind if I jump in?
Yeah, no.
Like, looking from outside, it looks like huge. Okay, so that's a first. I never seen this. You have a movable, adjustable steering column.
Hmm? So you can get out in and out of the car.
Man, this thing's cool as hell. Wow.
Everybody needs one.
I was thinking the same. So she used to have adjustable, right? It was like some kind of like a lock and go sliding up and down, right?
Down is all, yeah.
Now this thing can do a lot. Look at this thing. Wow. Hey, you want to drive?
Yeah, sure. Let me just run beside you.
Man, this thing's cool. Wow. So was last year the first year of this thing?
Yep.
So this is the second season?
Yep.
For her?
Yep.
And she's making 30 years?
Huh?
She's making 30 years?
30 years.
She's 93, right?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Look, she's a 30.
30. Yeah.
Look at this
thing.
30,
so yeah, 30 something, yeah.
When is her birthday, do you know? That's a cool deal, right?
Yeah.
That's a cool deal. Man, that's really cool. 30 years.
I
like wagons. Like, this is the coolest wagon I've ever seen. Like, when you showed me the photos the first time, like, oh, keep this low profile, this is secret. It's like, damn, man, this is just freaking badass.
Yep.
This is cool. What are we doing today?
Sorting out all little issues. Looks like we got the e-gates sorted out. That was the biggest deal. We can just clean up, tune up a little bit. Not super concerned about that.
Want to
work on my creep, and I think we probably had most of that figured out. Let me see what kind of horsepower makes it, like 40 pounds of boost, something like that.
Mm-hmm. When you went 650, 650s, you said, right?
Yep.
What kind of boost you had there?
There, that was with the 98 millimeter turbos. Oh, okay. It made 50 pounds of boost.
Okay.
So then I went, after I put these turbos on, I tested with the car, exact same tune-up, with just the turbo change, and it went the faster eighth mile with those at 40 pounds of boost than I did at 50 pounds of boost.
So that's why you want to go 40 and see?
Yeah, we'll just see where it's at right now. So I know it would go six, probably go six
40s,
40s right mm-hmm. here mm-hmm. at 40 pounds of boost.
Okay, so we're going to try to simulate a 640 lap. See how much power it makes.
Well, this first Thanks. One's just to make sure that the e-gates are doing
oh,
what we want.
Come on, I was like, oh, excited, like, we're about to send this
thing. It's going to be 25 pounds, then we can do 40 pounds.
Okay. It's not that bad. It's not like, let's do 5 pounds. Like, come on, bud. Come on, bud. Okay, so 25 for start?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, 25 for start.
Yep, just to get bearings on everything, and then we can go right to the full jam.
Okay. That ain't full 40. Jam. 40 is like the baseline, bud.
Well, I know. That's easy. That will be the baseline.
Oh, I forgot to ask you. How large is this?
That is 572 cubes.
So that's a big boy.
Big motor, yeah.
So that's a big boy of twin turbos. Like, that's yep. cool. And you have a 3-speed lockup or no lockup?
No lockup.
So 3-speed, no lockup, and you have some overdrive unit or something?
No overdrive.
No overdrive unit?
Nope.
So 3-speed, no lockup, no overdrive unit, and what kind of rear you run on this thing? The ratio.
I think it's a 370.
Okay.
Or a 389, I can't remember which, but it's one of those, but that's why we run those on the street.
So that's your secret?
Yeah.
So you run big...
Street tire.
Yeah. Big mud tires out there to get some ratio. Man, that's a tall tire. This is taller than your race tire, right?
Yeah, this is 37 and a half.
Wow.
And then that just gives me just that little bit of ratio.
Beautiful. Yep. So she rides along on the highway, what kind of RPM?
Like 25 to 28. And it's like 60 to 70 miles an hour, depends what
that's
we're doing.
Good. Yeah. That's good. No, that's good. That's good. Nice and fine. So the motor goes almost 9,000, you said, right?
Yep.
High 8,000, 87.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, it'll run 9,000.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. That's a pretty good idea, huh? You need ratio, yeah, put a big tire.
I would say that you're probably never going to get stuck.
That's right. It's my dune tire.
Yeah, like, oh, it's just snowing.
Yeah.
Don't care. You know? Oh, like the pavement is over. You're going to need to go through some mud. Don't care. Just keep going.
Yep, tractor through it.
Man, you had a great idea on this thing. I don't think I ever saw this.
That's wild. I didn't even notice that.
Just like some of the guys that come from like Drag Week's tire or something like that, they come up with like some badass tires and wheels. You know, there's, I think Mickey Thompson makes those like really
big, wide
and stuff. Like, it's not like this. It ain't this tall.
Yeah, you can't get any height out of them is the problem.
Yes, and so. I like this idea. This is actually a really good idea. I'm gonna think about it on my dude.
There you go.
Okay, let's make some noise.
Yep.
Make some noise. 25 pounds.
25 pounds.
25 pounds it is. Let's see what we have here with 25 pounds of Steve Moore's muscle.
Yes, sir.
You driving or I'm driving? I love the backup camera. Recovering, right? It didn't seem that was going to clean up. You could see the part was like, we'll be right back. some stuff that I want to claim, so people can correct me if I'm wrong. I think we did today the most powerful wagon on the face of Earth.
Could be.
Could Probably be.
Should be.
Okay. I want to see if
legit
you want to
wagon.
Know. Yeah, legit wagon.
Legit
so
wagon.
It has to have under all steel, all glass rules.
All steel, yeah.
All steel, all glass rules. So like if the carbon body, it's from factory, that's allowed. But if it's not, it has to be steel. So
stock body dimensions.
3,200
altered
horses. Or horses, yes. Like says my small kid. Horsey.
Yeah.
So 3,200 horses.
Yep.
So that's
on a low
much,
on a low boost.
Oh yeah, that was like 40 pounds, right?
Fat and unhappy tuna.
So I would say that's about what it took you to go 6 weeks.
Yep.
Right? About,
yep.
Maybe a little bit more, a little bit less, because it's kind of hard to take since it was a slightly different turbo combination.
Yep.
Right? 3,200. Then we try to do a next lap and see what it's going to make with a little bit more power, take some fuel out, make too much. We don't know how much you made. The transmission gave up on us.
Transmission broke.
Didn't
make it into second gear.
Yeah, so like you guys can see pretty much there because we have like torque and we have power and stuff. But like she was making 200 plus above when she like, I need to quit.
Yep.
I need an easier job, bud. Like you guys throwing too much power at me. Okay, so the quest for the five, right?
That's right.
That's what we said, the quest for the five. You guys gonna leave here.
Yep.
And you still haul ass to Bradenton.
Yep.
To test some.
Yep.
Get the spare transmission in.
Yep.
And try to go fives.
Ultimately, yes. We need to finish the event.
Okay, that's the order.
When
I get excited about going fives, that's why. I'm sorry.
Finish. Win.
Finish.
Then go fives.
Okay. So finish, win, while going 5 seconds.
While going 5 seconds.
Look at that thing.
Yeah. That sounds better.
Wow. Wow, right? So like winning.
Lord willing.
Okay.
So far, not willing.
Man, I'm going to tell you, I told you before, you're my hero. I know you for some time. And I'm honest, like I respect you tremendously because you're a guy that does so much. You pretty much develop engines, right? I remember when you showed me some like exquisite engines back at your shop, right?
Oh yeah.
Tune, drive, you know, run the business. And I understand nobody does on its own. You have, you know, your family, your kids is right here, right?
Yep.
So you people have a partner
help.
At the shop. You have, you know, people that work, but like, don't get me wrong, like people help, you know, you have a team.
Yep.
But you're the, you know, on the forefront of that, you know, you're leading the ship. That's really cool. So first of all, thank you for allowing
you.
Me to drive this thing on the dyno. It was such an amazing experience. I never drove a car like that, where like I looked to the side on the rear door.
Yeah, looking out the rear window.
Yeah, and then I never drove a car. I know that maybe like other cars that have like this, but I never seen like, it's a similar style chassis as a Promo. So this thing is like a kind of a mixed breed of like a badass 90s wagon with a pro mod.
Mm-hmm.
That's freaking cool. Like you achieved something almost impossible to achieve.
I guarantee you, this is the only one.
Oh, I bet there
is
money.
There is nothing
at least
like this.
There's nothing like
this.
You're saying like I'm looking to the factory door.
That's the door pillar, yeah.
Pillar,
factory door latch.
You know, latching everything. Like this is as close as you can get from a 90s wagon.
Yep.
But at the same time, it's as close as you can get to a Promo.
Yep.
That's freaking impressive. So like hats off to you, my friend.
Thanks.
Hats off to you. I like it. Well, you need to call your transmission guy because I know he's a badass dude.
Yep.
But you need to tell like, man, this thing actually
he'll fix it.
You need to do like a think about like a Pro Extreme Promo. That's what we need here.
Yep.
But she lasts for a pretty good life, right? Mm-hmm. She lasts for a pretty good life. And you know, sometimes we see that happen, you know, like you have like so many laps on it or something like that. It's a point it's gonna give up. I have like a 4080 on a truck that has a lot of power. I have like about 6 months span.
Yeah.
She runs really good for about 6 months, like, oh, I need to change clutches.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, so you're leaving today.
Yeah, we're gonna leave tonight. And head down there, and then by getting my spare transmission, blah blah, we're gonna make it happen.
When is the first lap?
Monday.
So we are here Tuesday.
So this video is not coming out today, obviously. So when you guys looking at me talking whatever bullcrap I'm talking now, it's like way past. We're gonna try to get some kind of footage from you guys, right? And if it's possible, we're gonna try to pull like and see if we go there, like, you know, taking the trophy, having good time in family, you know, like friends and family, and no less than having better personal best, but like achieving your goals, right?
Yep.
Finishing. Winning while going fast.
While going fast. Yeah, that'll be something.
Yeah, that'll be something. Okay, okay. Well, I'm gonna let you guys get after, you know?
Yep.
Put it back, put it on the box, right there. Transmission's gonna be on the way. You guys gonna kinda match, arrive in the same spot.
Yep.
Send me some information, bud. I'm gonna be watching.
All right, be watching.
Thank you so much.
All right, buddy.